สวัสดีค่ะ This video we gonna learn about the acid base titration titration is a common technique for conducting neutralization from previous lesson neutralization is a reaction between acid and base the product of this reaction is salt and water นะคะ if you are not sure about that goTo revise it again. In titration, common equipments are shown like this picture here. We need burette to control the speed of the solution here with this stopper. นะคะ the liquid or solution that add into the burette we call titrant. Normally, we know the concentration of this solution. In the flask,We add solution that we call sample or some textbook we call it analyte นะคะ it's a solution that we want to analyze the concentration นะคะ most of the time we want to know what is the concentration of the sample we can control the speed of the solution as I said control this stopper you can simply control how fast or slow the solution that come to mixTo each other. So we use this technique to find equivalence point between acid and base reaction. Equivalence point is the point where number of mole of acid and number of mole of base are equal according to stoichiometry. นะคะ Go back again if you are unsure how to calculate this. นะคะAnd sometimes equivalence point may not be seen or observed by eyes. So we need an indicator. Indicator would signal or identify what we call the endpoint. Endpoint should be in theory the same point as equivalence point. So the indicator here is very important.If you choose a good indicator, it will signal a good endpoint, which is the equivalent point. If you choose a wrong indicator, it will signal endpoint that is not equivalence point. We will see about that in this lesson, นะคะ So come to this very important two points in the titration.Equivalence point again นะคะ this is the point where acid and base have been brought together in exact stoichiometry or stoichiometric proportions so you need what a balanced chemical equation so you can find out the mole ratio between acid and base another point that is important in titration is the endpoint is the end of the titration where you stop adding the titrant into the sample นะคะ what is this point this would be the point where your indicator changes color so if you choose a good indicator as I said earlier these two points should be the same or close นะคะ if you choose the wrong indicatorThe endpoint may not be the point that you want, which is not equivalence point. So in acid-base indicator, what are they? They are a substance that show different colors in acidic and basic solution. This means that in acidic solution or pH lower than 7,This indicator will show one color. If you use the same indicator in a solution that is basic or pH higher than 7, it's gonna show you another color. Maybe this would be called a pH indicator because color changes according to pH. นะคะ It doesn't mean that pH change between acid and base, but different pH, the indicator.Also show different color, which is why P pH indicator is broader than acid-base indicator in my opinion. Why indicator change color in acidic or basic solution? This is because they are usually weak acid or weak base, which ionize in water produce their conjugate pairs. For example, the phenol red indicator can be shown as equilibrium like this. In acidic form, it is yellow. This one ionized in water produce hydronium ion and its conjugate base. The conjugate base has a red color. So if phenol red is put into acidic solution, the equilibrium will shift to the left and the solution will appear yellow. You remember about the shift of equilibrium from chapter number one, right? In acidic solution, there are gonna be a lot of hydronium ion. So this equilibrium would be shift to the left. The solution will appear in yellow. If you put phenol red in basic solution, the equilibrium will shift to the right. In basic solution has a lot of hydroxide ion. So hydroxide ion can react to this hydronium ion. So the equilibrium will shift to the right. The solution will appear red. From the equilibrium of weak acid as shown here, we can derive the equilibrium constant as Ka. This is Ka because a weak acid produces hydronium ion. Ka equal to hydronium ion concentration times conjugate base concentration divided by weak acid concentration. This is the equilibrium of indicator. So we change the K value to be K of indicator, which equal the same thing. If we take P function and rearrange this equation, we can come up with this pH equal to PK indicator plus log of concentration of base divided by concentration of acid. This is similar to the equation of buffer solution. From this equation, we can see that if pH changes, the ratio of these two species will change as well. And they have different color. If we have one in higher amount than another, it's gonna show the distinct color of that one. But if you have similar amount of these two, you will not see a distinct difference in color. And it is found that the color will be distinctly different over a range of pH that approximately to the pK indicator plus and minus 1. This is the property of acid-base indicator. We can see the indicator ranges like shown here in this picture. We have various type of indicator with different value of pK indicator from high value to low value here. The color change of alizarin yellow R is from yellow to red. The color change of thymol blue is red to yellow. And the range of color change will be around this pK indicator. So for example, methyl violet here has pK indicator 0.8. The color change from yellow to blue around this value plus and minus 1, approximate plus and minus 1. So 0.8 here, it changed from yellow to blue over this value. Let's see again Let's take a look at phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein here. pK indicator of phenolphthalein is 9.5. 9.5 is around here. So the range of color change would be plus and minus 1 of this 9.5 approximately. Okay. So we see that indicator change color over a range of pH. It doesn't change from one color to another at a specific pH. Bring back to the two important points in titration. We want to find out the equivalence point between acid and base. We want to find out the equivalence point between acid and base. We use indicator to signal the endpoint. So it's very important here that indicator must signal the endpoint that is the equivalence point. Okay. So if indicator change color because of the pH change, in titration, we must then have to answer this question. What is the pH at equivalence point? If we know the pH at equivalence point, we can select indicator that change color at that pH, right? So we have to find the indicator that change color around the pH at equivalence point. What is a good indicator? A good indicator should have a pK indicator value that is close to the expected pH at equivalence point. This is related to what we learned earlier that the indicator would change color around its pK indicator. So if we know the expected pH at equivalence point, this pH should be approximate to the pK indicator so that indicator will change color. When we do titration between acid and base, and we know that acid and base can be categorized into a strong and weak type. So the combination between titrant and sample can be titrant is a strong base, sample is a strong acid, or titrant is a strong base, sample is a weak acid. When we talk about the titration, we will use this pattern. We talk about titration of sample. Titration of sample with a titrant. So here are the four combinations. Titration of strong acid with strong base. When you see something like this, you have to think of the strong acid that is your sample with titrant. So strong base would be your titrant. Titration of strong acid, strong acids is your sample with strong base. The strong base is titrant. So we will discuss the titration in four types here. We have strong acid as sample, strong base as titrant. We use the same titrant, we change sample. Okay. Before we move on, make sure that you know this. You should be able to identify strong acid or base from the weak acid or base. If you can remember or memorize the strong acid and strong base here. We have 7 strong acid and 8 strong base only นะคะ In order to find out what is the pH at equivalence point, we may follow the progress of acid-base titration by monitor the pH change by plot the pH value of sample as a function of the amount of titrant added. And this plot is called a pH curve. And we use titration to do this, so it may be called a titration curve as well. We plot the pH of sample. So it depends on your sample. If it's an acid, the pH will start from low value. If your sample is a base, the pH will start from a high value. And once you add the titrant in, the pH will change. So we plot the value of pH change against the amount of titrant added. So we can see the pH curve that match the type of titration like this. Don't worry about how we can get the value just yet. Okay? We will study about the calculation of the pH during titration in the next lesson. Right now, just look at the general shape of the titration curves for different type of titration. This one, titration of strong acid with strong base, will have a general shape of titration curve like this. We have strong acid as sample. As I said, the pH will start from the low value. You add titrant as a strong base in, so the pH will slightly increase at first until we reach the equivalence point. At equivalence point of this titration, the pH will be 7. The pH will jump very quickly to the pH of the titrant because it is a strong base. The pH will be quite high. For the titration of strong base with strong acid, your sample is strong base. So the pH will start at a high value. When you add titrant as strong acid, the pH will slightly drop. Until you reach equivalence point, the pH will be 7. Change of pH is very subtly here. And after that, it's going to be pH of the strong acid. So these two, titration between strong acid, strong base, and strong base with strong acid, at equivalence point, the pH will be 7. Equivalence point for the titration of weak acid with strong base would be higher than 7. And the titration curve would look like this. Weak acid would have low pH, and then it will increase and then pass the buffer section. And at equivalence point, the pH will change suddenly again, and then followed by the pH of strong base. Equivalence point here would be higher than 7. The reason why we will learn later, นะคะ just wait a little bit. For the weak base and strong acid, the shape of titration curve would be like this. Start with pH of base. Decrease because adding strong acid. And then suddenly change at equivalence point. The equivalence point now would be lower than 7, and then followed by the pH of strong acid. So these are important curve for each type of titration. Now let's test your understanding a little bit. Which should be a titration curve for a titration of hydroiodic acid with โพแทสเซียมไฮดรอกไซด์ Pause and think about it นะคะ And here should be the dehydration of strong acid hydroiodic acid is a strong acid right with potassium hydroxide which is strong base the curve for dehydration of strong acid with strong base should be this one start with pH of strong acid and add tritran at strong base in pH increase and then change pH very suddenly after that is a pH of strong base let's try another one which should be dehydration curve for dehydration of hydrocyanic acid with calcium hydroxide think about it นะคะ here is a dehydration of weak acid with strong base hydrocyanic acid is a weak acid calcium hydroxide is a strong base so which should be its dehydration curve the answer would be this one pH of weak acid adding tritran strong base in pH increase and then change suddenly at the equivalence point followed by the pH of strong base. So hopefully you get it right. Now let's try to match good indicator to each type of dehydration. Let's start with dehydration of strong acid with strong base here. Sample strong acid, tritran strong base. Dehydration curve, pH of strong acid is low first, and then increase when we add strong base. Change suddenly at equivalence point, and then follow by pH of strong base. We can see that strong acid with strong base equivalence point change pH very big gap here, start from around 3 to around 11. From previous slide, when we talk about the good indicator, we have a conclusion that good indicator should have pK indicator that approximate to the equivalence point pH. In this particular one, the equivalence point has pH equal to 7. Among these various type of indicator, Brom Thymol Blue has the pK indicator around 7.3, which very close to this equivalence point pH. So it should be a good indicator. However, since the change of pH at this equivalence point is very high, big gap here, we can also use all these indicator as good indicator because the color change is also occur at this particular volume of tritran added. So when we add tritran to this amount, the pH change suddenly from 3 to 9 or 10. So Brom Phenol Blue that change color around 5 to 6 can be good. Methyl Red change color around 5 to 6 is also good. Phenolphthalein change color between 8 and 10 is also good. All of this will signal the endpoint that show the endpoint at the amount of tritran added equal to the equivalence volume. Where this one and this one are not good.
This timer blue will signal the endpoint before the equivalence point, where alizarin yellow R will signal the endpoint after the equivalence point. Compare the hydration curve of strong acid with strong base to strong base with strong acid. Because the change of pH at the same range, so all the good indicator here can be used in this one as well. Now move to the hydration of weak acid and strong base. The hydration curve change, one that you see quite obvious, is that the gap of pH change at equivalence point is now less or narrower. At equivalence point, the pH change from slightly more than 6 to 10. So only phenolphthalein is a good indicator here. Methyl red would signal the endpoint before equivalence point. Compare to the hydration of weak base with strong acid. Now, the methyl red is a good indicator for this one. Phenolphthalein, if you use this, it will signal the equivalence point. No, it will signal the endpoint before equivalence point. So you can see now that you have to know the expected pH at equivalence point to be able to select a good indicator. When we know what indicator should be used, we can do a titration and not follow the pH value. We just watch the change of color and stop the titration. Now that we learn about different type of titration, let's put these two in comparison. Titration of strong acid with strong base and titration of weak acid with strong base. If the acid are both monoprotic acid and with the same concentration, what would be the result of this titration? Let's have a look here. Answer this question. What is the volume of sodium hydroxide needed at equivalence point for each titration? If we use hydrochloric acid, which is a strong acid, 0.100 molar, 25 milliliter, titrate with sodium hydroxide, 0.100 molar as well. What should be the volume of sodium hydroxide needed at equivalence point compared to the sample, that is acetic acid, weak acid, same concentration, same volume? Can you do this? You may need to pause the lesson. Pause it, nakha, and try to figure out the answer. Here is the answer for hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. The mole ratio is 1:1. So this is number of mole of acid is equal to number of mole of base. 1:1. We need to find out the volume of base that needed for neutralize this amount and concentration of acid. Substitute all the value in 0.100 molar hydrochloric acid, 25 milliliter volume of hydrochloric acid. concentration of the tritran or base sodium hydroxide, volume of sodium hydroxide would be 25 milliliter. And this is for the weak acid and strong base. Number of mole of acid equal to number of mole of base. Stoichiometry 1 to 1, the same. So volume of sodium hydroxide would be 25 milliliter as well. So you can see here that if the acid are both monoprotic acid, same concentration, same volume, we will need the same amount of tritran or base to neutralize the acid. What would be different? The difference would be the titration curve, as we saw earlier. For the strong acid with strong base, we will get this pH curve. For weak acid with strong base, we will get this pH curve. The pH at equivalence point for the strong acid would be 7. pH at equivalence point for weak acid would be more than 7. Conclusion. If we compare the titration of strong acid with strong base to the weak acid with strong base, if the acid are monoprotic acid with same concentration, the volume of tritran or strong base needed at equivalence point are the same. The pH value of solution at equivalence point are different. The reason for the pH at the equivalence point are different can be seen by understanding the reaction that happened. Look at here first, the strong acid hydrochloric with strong base sodium hydroxide produce the product salt sodium chloride. And this salt come from strong base and strong acid. The ion that separate here would be sodium ion and chloride ion. No hydrolysis with this ion. pH would be equal to the pH of pure water. If you are unsure about this part, you need to go back to chapter 2. Look at the section about pH of salt solution. Come here. The weak acid react to strong base. The salt that produce are the salt of strong base with weak acid. This salt ionize in water, give conjugate base, which can be hydrolysis in water and produce weak acid with hydroxide ion. Because we have this hydroxide ion, so the equivalence point will have pH more than 7. So these are the reason why pH at equivalence point will be 7 for strong acid strong base, more than 7 for weak acid strong base. When we put the pH curves of the two types of titration before together in the same graph, we can see this. At equivalence point, we need the same volume of tritran or strong base, same volume. The difference is the shape of the curve before equivalence point here. The strong acid that has same concentration as the weak acid will have lower pH. This is the pH of strong acid would be lower. pH of weak acid would be higher. At equivalence point, pH suddenly change. After that, both will have the same value of pH because this is the pH of strong base solution. If we change the acid to be weaker and weaker acid, the titration curve would be looking like this. This is the weaker acid. The part that is different would be before equivalence point. After that would be the same. And the gap of pH at equivalence point will be narrower and narrower when we get weaker acid. For the strong acid, the gap is from around 3 up to 10. For the weakest acid here, the change of pH is only this point. So it will be more difficult to find a good indicator when we titrate weak acid. So hopefully you get the idea of the shape of pH curve for different types of titration. Bring back this slide again. The reason for equivalence point higher than 7, the equivalence point lower than 7. We see the reason for this one already, titration of weak acid and strong base, because of the hydrolysis of conjugate base that produce hydroxide at equivalence point. So equivalence point would be having pH more than 7. How about this one? Let's see the example. These are reaction for the weak acid titrate with strong base because of the hydrolysis of conjugate base here produce hydroxide, pH is more than 7. On this one, weak base titrate with strong acid produce dissolve. Dissolve separate into ammonium ion and chloride ion. The ammonium ion is the conjugate acid that hydrolyze give hydronium ion. Because of this hydronium ion at equivalence point, so the pH would be less than 7. Last one on this set of slide on this video, compare this time between strong acid. One is monoprotic, another one is diprotic. If you need to answer this question, what is the volume of sodium hydroxide needed at equivalence point? Can you do the calculation? We did for hydrochloric acid already, right? And this is the volume of sodium hydroxide needed. Do you think you will get the same volume for sulfuric acid or not? You may need to pause the lesson and find out what would be the volume of sodium hydroxide needed for the equivalence point. Here is the answer. Don't forget this stoichiometry coefficient for sodium hydroxide. So this is 1 to 2 mole ratio. Make this relationship. Don't forget this number 2 here that would be divided on this side. Rearrange and find out the volume of sodium hydroxide needed at equivalence point. The answer would be 50 milliliter. So diprotic acid would need double amount of the strong base to reach equivalence point when they have the same concentration. How about the pH curve? This is the pH curve for the hydrochloric acid with sodium hydroxide. Equivalence point is 25 milliliter of sodium hydroxide. The shape of pH strong acid with strong base. The change of pH is quite high here. How about the sulfuric acid? Can you make up the pH curve for this one? Pause นะคะ and think about it. Here should be the graph of sulfuric acid. We calculated that the volume of sodium hydroxide need for equivalence point is 50. So the pH will change suddenly at this volume. In summary, we learn about titration, that is the method to conduct acid-base neutralization. We need to select indicator. A good indicator would signal the endpoint, which should be very close to equivalence point. So expected pH at equivalence point must be known in order to select this good indicator. We see different pH curves, that is, depend on the types of acid and base involved in the titration. And that's it for this video. I see you in the next lesson. สวัสดีค่ะ